Welcome to South Asia. This is Jay Reddy, your facilitator at South Asia. South Asia is an educational channel where I will bring the knowledge about South Asian region, south of Karakoram Mountains, north of Kanyakumari. And I strongly encourage all my followers who liked our intellectual discourses and the knowledge about South Asian history, geography, culture, please go to YouTube channel for South Asia Maps plus J Reddy, and please access from there and start posting your comments from there. You can go to the playlist. We have more than 70 or so videos. Madras Presidency, Bombay Presidency, and we have in the playlist, and the treaties and wars, the Maratha Empire, the my favorites, musings, reflections, Punjab history, the various districts in India, district of Bangladesh, Pakistan, the Deccan region, current politics and decline of Congress Party, central provinces, Hyderabad, Nizamia, miscellaneous topics, Mughal Empire and railway history and so on. Please go there and you can look at the high quality videos I have posted there, and that will be great help in propagating our channel. And coming back to the today's topic of discussion will be the Madras Presidency. That's what we have been discussing, the growth of Madras Presidency. Madras Presidency was a part of British India. It was an administrative subunit of British India, that is the presidencies, provinces, agencies, residencies, princely states and so on. Now we are discussing about Madras Presidency, its growth, how the territory expanded in Madras Presidency from a small trading post to a vast territorial entity. And part 3, please pay attention to this part. I have covered part 0, that is essentially a broad Madras Presidency growth. Part 1, like the Madras Presidency and Chengalpet district acquisition. And second part, I covered the Northern Sarkars here. This map doesn't have it. The part 3, we are covering today, how British East India Company Bahadur acquired Baramahal region, Dindigul region, Malabar region in 1792. This is the Baramahal region, this is the Dindigul region, this is the Malabar region. This is the princely state of Mysore, this is the princely state of Cochin, this is the princely state of Travancore or Thiruvakkanur or Wayanad. We have a princely state of Kodagu or Coorg here. We have Goa, Portuguese colony Goa, and princely state of Banganpalli in Karnool district, princely state of Sandur here, not shown, in Bellary district, a princely state of Pudukkottai in southern Tamil Nadu, bordering Tanjavur district, Tiruchirappalli district and Madurai district. And after this presentation, these things will be very clear to you. You will get a good understanding. Excuse me for the allergies. And as you know, that Madras Presidency is one of the three presidencies, historical presidencies British had. Madras Presidency, Bombay Presidency, and of course Bengal Presidency or Calcutta Presidency. Madras Presidency territorial area extended from Aramboli Pass on Agastya Malai Mountains or Hills or Sahyadri Mountains or Western Ghats to Chilkal Lake in Kalinga Coast on Bay of Bengal or Ganga Sagar to Karwar region, Kali Nadi River or Kalindi River in North Kanara. It has an agency division. There are five divisions: Sarkar division, Deccan division, Coromandel division, West Coast division. Agency division is Gajapati district, Berhampur district, or Vizag district, Visakhapatnam. And Sarkar sees like Godavari districts, Krishna district, Guntur and Nellur. Then Dakkani division is the ceded district, the ceded area or Rayalaseema area, Ballari, Karnool, Anantapur, Kadapa, Chittur here. Then of course Coromandel division, that is Tamil speaking areas, North Arcot, South Arcot, Chengalpattu, Tiruchirappalli and Tanjavuru and Madurai. Excuse me, Tirunelveli, Coimbatore, Nilagiris, and finally West Coast Division, that is North Kannada, South Kannada, Malabar. That is in brief about Madras Presidency. That has nearly 26 districts we covered in 5 divisions. Madras Presidency survived from 1639 to final dismemberment after partition independence round about 1940s and 50s, almost 300 years, and it has a tremendous influence on the lives and culture of this area. That in order to understand deeply the society, you have to understand excuse me, what happened in that. So essentially we are dealing today the political history, the military history of the growth of Madras Presidency, and the third phase, the acquisition of Baramahal district or area, Dindigul area and Malabar area in 1792. The overnight the British East India Company's territory of Madras Presidency increased tremendously. That will be the today's topic of discussion. Before that, the Madras Presidency started during the Arayavidu dynasty of the declining Vijayanagara Empire round about 1640s. Arayavidu kings, emperors gave a territory called Madras, at that time Chennapatnam, to build a trading post for the British. Francis Day, around about 1684, when Shivaji at Raigad crowned himself as the emperor of Marathas, the same time Madras, the trading post, elevated itself into a Madras Presidency. That means the Maratha started at that time, the British started. The final contest after Battle of Panipat, 1761 January, occurred in the sequel Buxar, where the British won and eventually Marathas lost. The nationalist lost and British imperialism formally replaced Islamic imperialism of Mughals. During that declining era of Mughals and Marathas, three wars were fought in the Carnatic region as a part of the global French and British conflict throughout the planet Earth. These wars were fought by their proxies, East India Company, British East India Company, and French East India Company. They have branches in many places, but important battles fought in Pondicherry and Madras. This region is called at that time Carnatic region. That is different from Karnataka province or state today we have in Deccan, with Bangalore as a capital. So that is very different. Carnatic region essentially means from Aramboli Pass in Tirunelveli district to almost Ongole Prakasham district in this area. South of Gundlakamma River, there is a Penna River. South of Penna River to Kaveri River is the central Carnatic. North of Penna River in Nellur is northern Carnatic. South of Kaveri River is southern Carnatic. Carnatic essentially equals to Tanjavur Tiruchirappalli Delta area. That name broadly historically applied. ruled in those times by Nawab of Carnatic at Arcot on Pala River near Vellore. So it's also called Carnatic Nawab or Arcot Nawabi or Nawabs. So three wars were fought, the first war, second war, third war. First war ended by Treaty of Axila Chapel, second war Treaty of Pondicherry, third war in 1763 Treaty of Paris. First war tested the waters. Testing the waters means small French army defeated a vast army of Nawab of Arcot at First Carnatic War near Adyar River at St. Thom area in Madras city now, called Battle of Adyar, Battle of St. Thom. Local Sipahis defeated. At that time, the governor of French East India Company at Pondicherry at the mouth of Ponniyar River near in South Arcot district area was François Duplay. He realized he can now play prominent role in the Deccani politics. And there was no territorial changes between the British and English at that time. But Duplay was waiting for an opportunity. Opportunity came within few months. Nizam of Hyderabad passed away at that time. There was a vacancy for the throne. And vacancy was filled by his son, Nazir. And there were two claimants, Muzaffar Jung and Nasir Jung. Nasir Jung was the son, Muzaffar Jung was the grandson. And in Karnataka also, Arcot, there was a two contenders, Chanda Sahib and Muhammad Ali. French decided to support Chanda Sahib here and Muzaffar Jung here. So initially they were successful, they established and their rule and Nizam in Aurangabad, Hyderabad. But later years when the Clive took over at the generalship, French were defeated. As the result of Pondicherry Treaty, French held their domination at Nizam's court, British held their domination at Arcot. In Arcot, in Nawab, Muhammad Ali Khan Walaza came under their control. They were the de jure rulers, means they were the prominent controllers of the Arcot Nawab. Within few years, within 2 years, third war broke down. That is 1756 to 63, French were decisively defeated and decided they were forced to accept the Treaty of Paris and remained a trading company with no political ambitions. Third Carnatic War made the British the prominent contenders for the domination of India. At that time, Maratha, declining Maratha Empire at Pune. And within few months after the treaty, the beneficiary of the war and who was beholden to the British East India Company, Bahadur, Muhammad Ali Khan Wallaza, gave the surrounding territories around Madras town, Chennapatnam town, where British has a trading post and a factory and a small cantonment at Fort St. George called Chengalpattu region, that is Saidapet, Chengalpattu, Kanchipuram, Perambaduru and Ponnani, Gummidipandi, Thiruvalluri, Thiruthani, all those areas, Madurantakam, Mahabalipuram, those areas were given. So the British has a Madras urban area plus surrounding Chengalpattu district. At the same time, British also defeated Nawab of Awadh at Faizabad and Lucknow, Nawab of Bengal and Mughal Emperor at Buxar on the banks of Ganga in Bihar, and Treaty Allahabad, they became the masters of Bengal, and Mughal Badshah Shah Alam gave them the Sarkars, northern Sarkars, which were under French control. So British already conquered them from French, from Bussi, and they actually acquired it by de facto. And Mughal Emperor Shah Alam now gave them formally, because Mughal Emperor really doesn't have anything, but it's a formal acknowledgement. And then Nizam, which was nominally under the control of Mughal Emperor Shah Alam Shani, also signed a treaty called Machilipatnam, that is Krishna district Machilipatnam, Bandar or Machilipatnam, and gave these territories formally. So we saw acquisition of Chengalpattu district, acquisition of Northern Sarkar. Now the main part, acquisition of Baramahal, acquisition of Dindigul, acquisition of Malabar in 1792. That means the war, Third Mysore War, broke down between the British East India Company Bahadur and the ruler of Mysore Kingdom. At that time, Tipu Sultan, who usurped the Wadayar dynasty, his father usurped it 1761, and he died fighting the second war in 1784, and Tipu succeeded. He was very the militant Islamic zealot, and he made lot of enemies with Nizam, with Marathas and British. All of them combined, the Marathas, Nizam, British East India Company, called a tripartite alliance, a triple alliance. And when the war broke down between the Tipu Sultan and triple alliance, finally Tipu was defeated in 1792. And after the defeat, he shed lot of his territory, nearly half of the territory. Here we are concerned mostly about the expansion of Madras Presidency. Tipu gave these areas which I highlighted in yellow. This is the Baramahal region, are called Salem. There are a lot of forts there, Mahals, forts, Baramahal. Now it's called, British called later, Salem district. This is the Dindigul in the mountainous area. This is the Malabar. And Tipu also gave the territory south of Tungabhadra, that is called later ceded district, Ballari, Karnool, Anantapur, Chittur, to Nizam. Because of the triple alliance, these areas were given to Nizam. And Dharwar and Karwar, these areas, Dharwad and those areas, were given to Marathas. And British acquired these three areas. Baramahal is a, there are eastern ghats here, and there is a Kaveri river that descends here. The north of Kaveri and south of eastern ghats is called Baramahal. Essentially, on the outskirts of Bangalore district, there is a Hosur, then Kanikota, then you have Krishnagiri, then you have Dharmapuri and Harur district and Pennagaram. All these areas, as well as Omalur and Mettur and Salem district, Salem. Then we have Namakkal, Rasipuram and Attur. At that time, this entire bigger area, now there's four districts there, is called Baramahal area, or enlarged Salem district, this area. Then Tipu also gave this area called Dindigul, Dindigul, Namakkal, Nettam, and all those areas. There is the Varishanad mountains here, and Palani mountains here, Kodai Canal, and all those areas. There is a very big fort, Dindigul, that is a gateway from Tiruchirappalli to Madurai. That is close to Madurai. This is called Dindigul. Then the Malabar region means Palakkad, Ottupalem and Shoranur and Ponneni, Thanur, Thirur, Manjeri, Irnad, Valluvanad and Calicut or Kozhikode, then Badagara, Kilandi, Wayanad, Kannanur, Telicheri, all this area at that time called historical Malabar district. This provided seaboard to the Tipu Sultan. Tipu Sultan gave this entire Malabar district to the British in 1792, after Third Mysore War. That means Third Anglo-Mysore War. The result of that war is called Treaty of Srirangapatnam. Srirangapatnam is a city in the Dwab region of Kaveri. Kaveri branches there and again joins. That small town is called Srirangapatnam and capital of Tipu, administrative center. Maharaja Vadayar Maharaja lived at the foothills of the Malnad region called Mysuru or Mysuru. Tipu ruled from and Srirangapatnam. So, Treaty of Srirangapatnam gave the British these three areas. Remember, these three areas were not geographically contiguous. The Baramahal district, the Dindigul district and Malabar district were separated by still Tipu's territory, that is Coimbatore and Nilgiris. And the British didn't acquire that one. Already British had Chengalpatt district here surrounding Madras. British already had by that time Guntur Sarkar after the death of Basalat Cheng. The north of Krishna River, they already acquired the northern Sarkar, that is today's Krishna district, West Godavari district, Yelur, and East Godavari district, Rajahmundry and Kakinada, and Vijayakapatnam district, Srikakulam and Ganjam, and all those areas. So these areas British controlled, and they controlled Madras, Chengalpatt district. Now they got these three districts after Third Mysore War, that is the Treaty of Srirangapatnam. I have mentioned here 1792. That is in brief about the enlargement of Madras Presidency, growth of Madras Presidency, or territorial expansion of Madras Presidency, a third phase, acquisition of Baramahal, that is Salem, acquisition of Dindigul, north of Madurai district and Vaigai, acquisition of Malabar, that is the Calicut or Kozhikode region. Now we'll go and look at these things in the map, and I will show you what is the Baramahal district. Remember, in 1792 the Tipu Sultan gave Baramahal region to the British. This is the Baramahal region. You have Salem here, Dharmapuri. This sea, you can see the Baramahal, that is Hosur, Denkanikotta, Krishnagiri and Palakkodu, Pennagaram, Dharmapuri, Harur and Uttangaroy. These are now in Dharmapuri, Krishnagiri area. This entire thing is Baramahal at that time. Then you have Mettur, Omalur and Erkod Hill Station, Shankaridurg, Shelam and Namakkal, Rasipuram, Trichangodu, Attur. This is the Baramahal district, the Salem, Dharmapuri, Krishnagiri, Namakkal area, and also gave Dindigul. So it got Kodaikkanal, Neelakottai, Dindigul, Nattam. It's not exactly taluks, the areas overlapping these areas. These two Tipu gave to British, and Tipu Sultan, who is a usurper of Vadayar kingdom, already at the same time gave northern Malabar region. The Malabar region is a Palakkad, Manarkad, Vattupalam. We are looking at the Malabar region, today's Kerala. You can see the broader. This is the Malabar region, and this is the Malabar district, the British Malabar district. He gave Palakkad, Vattupalam, Manarkad, and this Malappuram or Ernadu, and Malappuram, Tirur and Ponnani, Chavakkad taluka for today's Thrissur district. Of course, Alathur and Chittur were in the Kochi principality. They were not British territories acquired. And Kozhikode district, Calicut or Kozhikode, and Kilandi and Badagara, and Wayanad district, Vaitri, Sultan Battery, Manarkad, and Kannur district. Mahi was a French enclave. Exclave Mahi and British exclave Telicherry, already British had it, and Kannur and Talliparamba. These were the Malabar region given by the Tipu Sultan to the British after the Third War. So essentially we are looking at the same thing here, and we have we have here Pondicherry French colony, and Chennai and Kanchipuram, that is Chengalpattu district, and we have the Eastern Ghats here, and we have Bengaluru, where the British resident later lived, and at that time the Tipu's territory, and Krishnagiri and Dharmapuri and Salem, the Mettur Dam and Attur Gap here, Namakkal and Tiruchengodu, and also Dindigul. You see the here the Palani mountains here, the Palani, Kodaikanal, those area. Dindigul is the historic fort that guarded the Madurai in the southern part and Vaigai, and these territories were given by the Tipu Sultan in the Third War to the British East India Company Bahadur. So that's what I talked today about, the growth of Madras Presidency in the part 3, the acquisition of Baramahal, Dindigul, Malabar in 1792. So essentially we looked at all the 26 districts of Madras Presidency at its zenith, that means the largest territorial expansion in 5 divisions, that is Agency Division, Sarkar Division, Deccan Division, Coromandel Division, Tamil Division, West Coast Division, that is North Kannada, South Kannada and Malabar. And this is your presenter J. Reddy at South Asia Maps. Please subscribe our educational channel and promote it. And we'll see you in our next presentation of the growth of the Madras Presidency part 4 very soon. Thank you very much and see you later. This is J. Reddy in South Asia Maps, the educational channel bringing the knowledge in the form of icons and maps about South Asia to our audience.